And now it's time to learn how to record writing checks from our bank account in QuickBooks. Writing checks is absolutely not the same thing as paying bills. Paying bills in QuickBooks is an accounts payable function, and managing your relationship with vendors in the accounts payable section is a different part of this course. Paying bills means you're paying for a service that we received in the past, a service that we received before the day that we're paying. We're paying bills that were previously recorded into QuickBooks as bill entries for past transactions. The writing checks feature in QuickBooks is the exact opposite. You only open the write a checks window if you're paying at the moment you receive the product or service. So try to remember, writing a check means you're paying immediately. For example, on March 30, Holden wrote check number 100 to UPS for a delivery done exactly on March 30. That means Holden paid them immediately, and the appropriate window to record this transaction is the write a checks window. It's very simple to copy this information into the write a checks window, but one thing you must be aware of, this is a handwritten check. A handwritten check means it's not printed from QuickBooks, which means at the moment you record this check, you have to put the check number in the check number field. And you have to make sure that the check number field is showing by clicking the appropriate command in the ribbon. From the main menu, click Banking, Write a Check. Make sure the main tab is selected so that you can see the Print Later command in the ribbon. Usually, this command is checkmarked if it's the first time you're opening this window. If this command has the check mark in it, it means you're not physically able to record the check number. You must click to remove the check mark in the Print Later command so that you're physically able to type in the number of the handwritten check. In this case, it's number 100. The date of this check is March 30th, and the vendor whom we're paying is UPS. The money amount we're paying is $500, and we push Tab to save the money in the money field. Notice when we save the money in the money field, QuickBooks automatically writes out the money amount in words, the way it would be on a handwritten check. The last piece of information you have to put is the reason why we are paying the vendor. We are paying UPS for a delivery. We move the mouse to the bottom left directly under the word account, and we click once to bring the pull-down arrow. We click on the pull-down arrow and we choose the account in the chart of accounts that represents the reason why we are paying UPS. In this case, we're paying UPS for delivery expense, so that would be the ledger account that we choose when we record the check. After we click Save, cash in bank should decrease because we paid $500 from cash in bank. And delivery expense should show up for the first time on the trial balance as $500. When we click Save and Close, we open the trial balance and we see delivery expense has showed up in the trial balance for the first time as $500. If we double-click Cash in Bank, we can look at the very last transaction that was recorded, and we see on March 30th, we recorded a check to UPS for delivery expense, which reduced the bank account by $500. Now let's try this one. On March 31, Holden wrote check number 101 to Verizon for a prepaid phone card, $700. Remember, this is a handwritten check, not printed from QuickBooks, so you have to make sure that the command in the ribbon is not checked off to make sure we're able to put in the check number. From the main menu, we click Banking, Write a Check. Notice QuickBooks remembers that the last check was check 100 and suggests that this check number is 101. We agree with that, and therefore we won't change it. Click on the date box to put the date as March 31. The vendor in this case is Verizon, and the money amount is $700. Push tab to save the money field, and QuickBooks will write it out in words like a handwritten check. Now we have to tell QuickBooks the reason why we're paying Verizon $700. Move to the bottom left and click once under the word account. Click on the pull-down arrow and choose the account within our chart of accounts that represents the reason why we're paying Verizon. In this case, it's telephone expense. When we click Save and Close, we can see that telephone expense has shown up on the trial balance for the first time as $700. When we double-click Cash and Bank, we can see that the very last transaction is March 31st, check 101 to Verizon, and it reduced our bank balance by $700. It is very important to remember that any reduction to the bank account can be recorded in the Write a Checks window. This is true even if you're not physically writing a check. For example, on April 1, Holden withdrew from an ATM machine $300 cash to buy new supplies from Staples. The unique transaction number is written on the source document, and in this case, the source document is the ATM slip. So we will use this number to identify the transaction. From the main menu, click Banking, Write a Check. The date is April 1. And remember, instead of putting a check number, you put the number on the ATM slip, because the ATM slip in this example is the source document, and the number on the ATM slip is the unique transaction number that identifies the April 1 withdrawal. The people who got the cash were actually Staples, because they're the ones whom Holden paid the cash to. He took $300 from the bank account, and in the bottom left of the window, he's going to click and choose supplies, because the reason the money came out of this bank account was because the money paid for new supplies. So we have all the information we need for this ATM withdrawal, and when we click Save and Close, we notice supplies has shown up on the trial balance for the first time as $300, and cash in bank has been reduced by $300 for this ATM withdrawal. If we double-click cash in bank, we can see April 1 is the latest transaction in the account, and it reduces the bank account by $300, and I can stretch the column wider to make sure I can see the number on the ATM slip.